Using the digits 2 through 8, find the number of different 4-digit numbers under the given conditions. Notice using the digits 2 through 8, there are 7 possible digits. Number 1, the digits cannot be repeated and must be written in increasing order. For example, 2367 is okay, but 3267 is not. Every time we select a group of 4 digits from the 7 possible digits, there's only one possible 4-digit number that satisfies the condition in which the digits cannot be repeated and must be written in increasing order. And therefore, there are 7 choose 4 different 4-digit numbers in which the digits cannot be repeated and must be written in increasing order. And 7 choose 4 is equal to 7 factorial divided by the product of 7 minus 4 factorial and 4 factorial, which is equal to 7 factorial divided by the product of 3 factorial and 4 factorial, which is equal to 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 factorial divided by 3 times 2 times 1 times 4 factorial. Simplifying, 4 factorial divided by itself simplifies to 1. Notice in the denominator we have 3 times 2, which is 6. 6 divided by 6 simplifies to 1, leaving us with 7 times 5, or 35, different 4-digit numbers. There are 35 different 4-digit numbers in which the digits cannot be repeated and must be written in increasing order. For number 2, the digits can be repeated and must be written in non-decreasing order. For example, 2448 is okay, but 2484 is not. To answer this question, we will use the method of stars and bars. So to begin, because we're forming 4-digit numbers, we have 4 digit positions, indicating we have 4 stars. And because there are 7 possible digits, or we could say 7 possible distinguishable digits, we have 6 bars. The number of bars is always 1 less than the number of distinguishable items, which means every time we form a string of 4 stars and 6 bars, it represents a 4-digit number that satisfies the conditions in which the digits can be repeated and must be written in non-decreasing order. Let's look at 2 possible stars and bars charts. We begin with the digit of 2, and then because the first string starts with a bar, this indicates we switch to the digit of 3, and then we have a star which indicates we assign 3 to the first digit or leftmost digit of the 4-digit number. Next we have a bar, indicating we switch from 3 to 4, and then we have a star, and therefore 4 becomes the second digit in the 4-digit number. Next we have 3 bars, indicating we have 3 switches, indicating we switch from 4 to 5, then 5 to 6, and then 6 to 7. Next we have a star, which means we assign 7 to the third digit of the 4-digit number. Next we have another bar, indicating we switch from 7 to 8, and then we have the last star, indicating we assign 8 to the last digit of the 4-digit number. 3478 is a 4-digit number that satisfies the condition for number 2. Let's look at one more example. Notice in the next string we start with 2 bars, indicating we start with 2 switches, and therefore we switch from 2 to 3 and then 3 to 4, then we have a star. 4 is assigned to the first digit of the 4-digit number. Next we have a bar, and therefore we switch from 4 to 5. Next we have 2 stars, which indicates we assign 5 to the second and third digits of the 4-digit number. Next we have 2 bars, indicating we switch from 5 to 6, and then 6 to 7. And then we have a star. 7 is assigned to the last digit of the 4-digit number. And then we have a bar, indicating we switch to 8, but there are no more stars, and therefore we're done. So all the strings of 4 stars and 6 bars will give us all the possible ways we can form different 4-digit numbers in which the digits can be repeated and must be written in non-decreasing order. And there are 10 choose 6 possible strings. Notice how we can relate this to bit strings, where this is the same as the number of 10-bit strings in which we have 6 ones or of weight 6. We're using stars and bars. The number of ways is the sum of the stars and bars choose the number of bars, which again gives us 10 choose 6. And 10 choose 6 is equal to 10 factorial divided by the product of 10 minus 6 factorial and 6 factorial, which is 10 factorial divided by the product of 4 factorial and 6 factorial, Let's go ahead and simplify. 10 factorial is equal to 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 factorial. I'll divide it by 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 times 6 factorial. Simplifying, 6 factorial divided by itself simplifies to 1. In the denominator, we have 4 times 2, which is 8. 8 divided by 8 simplifies to 1. 9 and 3 share a common factor of 3. There's 1 3 and 3, and 3 3s and 9. We're left with 10 times 3 times 7, which is 210. There are 210 different four-digit numbers in which the digits can be repeated and must be written in non-decreasing order. I hope you found this helpful.